Atlas, before it became Marvel, had a distributor that I believe went under, and somehow the distribution of Marvel Comics was left to the people who distributed DC. And that went on until I think 1968. And DC was, or Marvel was restricted, I think it was 16 titles a month, which was why a lot of things were bi-monthly or even quarterly or whatever. So if you wanted to have that Billy the Model come out, you'd have to sacrifice Tales of Suspense or something like that. And they had that restriction, I believe it was till 1968. I think the number was 16 comics in 1 month, because DC was distributing Marvel is basically what it came down to. Then Curtis came along in 1968, and that's what kind of changed everything. Up to that point, the print runs were pretty high in a lot of Silver Age Marvels and DCs. I don't know, maybe 600,000. I think the Batman during the movie craze might have hit 800,000 or more. The strange thing is, people don't realize Archie was usually better selling than most of the superheroes in that period. But anyway, when Curtis came along and started distributing Marvel, that was Marvel's distributor, all of a sudden there was no restriction to how many books they could put on the newsstand. That's why, all of a sudden, Suspense and Astonish split into two books out of each, so you had four books instead of two. Those titles were canceled. Surfer number one's coming out, Iron Man number one's coming out, all the stuff's coming out. Give it a couple more years, they started experimenting with, you know, Conan and all these reprint books like, you know, Beware and Where Monsters Dwell and all this stuff. And that's why the explosion of comics on the newsstands in that late Silver Age, early Bronze Age period. All of a sudden we had probably four times as many titles in the stands. What it did is diluted the print runs. Instead of having 400,000 and 600,000 print runs, suddenly you'd have 250,000, 300,000 of print runs of these things. And it was a competition between Marvel and DC to fill the stands. So all of a sudden you had reprint titles, and eventually stuff like the Treasuries came out, and they tried the magazines, and they were just filling stands with anything they could print for a while there. What they did to themselves, though, is they diluted the print runs.